and they eat at
okay,
the
they can eat here.
Or they can bring their lunch bag and they will eat in the same space.
Also too, they
they don't need to be seated. This is one of my
to be seated.
No, it's just they can, they are free.
They are free to move. Yeah,
okay.
They're not sitting all day long at one table. They change, they choose their activity, they have a tag.
Okay.
They go around with their tag and see whether they want to do this or that. They have some like Montessori inspired activities when they can take a carpet, work on their floor.
Mm-hmm. And about the language, because my son is speaking English and Spanish, but no French, any French.
They will come.
Okay, but you will normally you will speak in French, I suppose.
Yeah, me, okay. I'll speak French, but when I have purely Anglophones arriving,
he speaks mixed,
but with no French, I have to use the English, otherwise
they're
totally lost. I mean, the first thing is that they have to feel integrated in a class and in a group, so you have something to use both. So what I would say, that I would say something in French and repeating in English for the child to understand.
Okay.
And then with time, I will reduce the English so that they don't also become lazy. And
my question
is
because here normally people wait until 4 or 5 years old to start school. You have more kids with 3 years old or not?
Yes, we have.
Yes.
We have a lot of them. We have 2 classes.
I want that he starts creating links with the friends. You know, it's like I don't want to wait too long.
No, he'll definitely make friends with kids here.
Yes.
Also speak French when they
but
go to
in the
house.
School that he's now every year change the kids because it's partly kids.
No,
here
yeah.
They wanted to create.
I've been friends with the same people since I was 4.
This I want this. Be nice.
So, yeah.
Okay.
So we have, this is the class for 5 to 6, but we have 2 classes from 3 to 4, 2 classes from 4 to 5, and 2 classes from 5 to 6.
And the timing normally is from the time of the day, the whole day, the class is...
From 8 to 2.30. With a break, 1 hour and a half break.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Here we can see that it doesn't vibrate as much because it's much higher frequency, and so it vibrates, but the vibrations are little and they're like close to each other. Here we can hear them a bit less because it's getting higher and higher, because you can see that the sounds we can hear are between 20 Hz and 20,000 Hz. Right now we're at 14,000. sodium hydroxide.
That is this one?
Yeah. We took 1.2 grams of it because that's how much we need. Yeah.
Now, what are we gonna do? It's take the sodium of hydroxide. Je mets tout, non?
This is the methadine blue, and we're gonna add 2 drops. Okay, now
we're gonna close it.
And we're gonna shake it well.
We're gonna shake it.
Color is, this is very transparent. This is what it looked like before, but now it looks a bit like this.
Like this before and this is after.
And now when you shake it again,
look.
Look at that. This blue is faded, but this blue is much more.
And
colorful.
We're gonna see the difference between which one gets transparent and faster.
Definitely, when I look at my former colleagues who were in the Lycée Français in Brussels, they all had amazing careers all over the world. Being in the Lycée Français is not only getting a hold of a French language, of course it is, and I was just talking with this lovely journalist a minute ago who was wondering, what shall we do for Ghana to speak French? And as you know, President Nana Akufo-Addo really wants Ghanaians to be bilingual. And French, well, definitely you're surrounded by French-speaking countries, left, right, above, and even the sea speaks French, I was told. So being in the French Lycée is not only speaking French, it is, of course, the basics, but it's also being multicultural, multinational, multilingual, this is a huge opportunity for the children to be in touch with so many different nationalities, so many different cultures, and it's a chance that will follow you up all your life and that you will remember. So to the kids, I want to say, whatever you learn here in the French Lycée, you will remember all your life, and that will be an asset for the rest of your life and career. You will make friends from all over the world, you'll make a network, and that's very important, and you'll open your mind, and that's probably one of the biggest asset you can have for your future life. And to the parents, I can say that it's probably the safest bet. Being in a French Lycée is giving your children a chance to have the state-of-the-art teaching. I very often say that I have lived until the baccalaureate from my knowledge that I got in the French Lycée when I was 12 and 13. Because then I went back to a French school and I didn't learn any more than I had learned in the Lycée Français in the sixth and fifth year. So you are really steps ahead. I can't thank you and congratulate you enough if you choose and that you choose the Lycée Français, and I wish you the best of luck and of course the best of luck future and careers to your children. Thank you very much. Let's go cocktail.
Sciences.